the press conference yesterday, you outlined how there are constitutional procedural safeguards against corruption and foreign influence in elections that should be put into place here. And even though you're not going to litigate this for the media, and you're going to do this through the courts, you do have a responsibility to inform the public of what you're doing, because we all need clarity. Business needs clarity. The public needs clarity to know where we're going in 2021. And is there something real here that would overturn what looks like Joe Biden coming in as the president? So what can you tell us in the way of evidence, Jenna, to help the public understand why you believe you can actually show and prove in a court of law that this election was rigged and that there were votes changed from Trump to Biden?
Yes, and that's exactly why we held the press conference yesterday, because you're right. We owe the American people to show them basically what we will prove in court. We have affidavits from witnesses. We have voter intimidation. We have the ballots that were manipulated. We have all kinds of statistics that show that this was a coordinated effort in all of these states to transfer votes either from Trump to Biden, to manipulate the ballots, to count them in secret. And we outlined that at the press conference yesterday. And for anyone in the mainstream media who's claiming that we didn't say or show that we have evidence, Rudy Giuliani went state by state saying exactly what we have.
All right, let me ask you about your timing now. We are expecting verification and certification of these elections in the state elections in early December. Are you going to be able to get this through the courts? You're going to be able to get heard, prosecute this within the next 2.5-3 weeks, Jenna?
I hope so. It is an uphill battle, and typically these types of enforced timelines on this small scale don't happen in litigation. So this is an uphill battle. I'm confident that Team Trump will do everything we can to make sure that false results aren't certified, and that's why the Constitution provides these safeguards. This isn't the first time in American history that a presidential election has had to go through other channels and constitutional methods. That was even beginning in 1800. So the American people need to recognize the history, why the Constitution is there, and that there are safeguards for corruption, or even if the election doesn't get to 270 for either candidate, or if there are any problems, that we don't disenfranchise the American people. So this isn't some kind of ridiculous thing that America is experiencing for the first time. That's why we have the Constitution that specifically contemplates how we get there before January 20th.
All right. We will be watching, Jenna. We'll have you back accordingly. Thank you so much.